G'day guys, my name is Pete Moriarty, and in this video I'm going to be covering why you may choose to use a G Suite account for your personal and family data. Now, if you're a business owner and you're using G Suite for your business data, you're quite possibly already familiar with how everything in the Google world works, but for most people, their personal accounts are still a Gmail account, or maybe you're just using everything in the one business account. You've got it all in one place. So this video is really about the magic of separating your business G Suite into a personal G Suite account. So you have two, you end up with two completely separate G Suite accounts. And the benefit of that, what that allows you to do is do some pretty cool stuff in the Google world. So this is a bit geeky, and this is how we take the more advanced businesses who are in the growth stage of working with us into more of the world of doing things the Google way after they've got all of the basics done. So if you haven't already checked out our videos on our growth roadmap, now would definitely be a good time to check that out. So let's get into our presentation, guys. I'm gonna be taking you guys through all of the good stuff on using your G Suite account to be used for your personal repository. And this is really about making sure that you have your data safe and secure. So who are we? Well, we're a small business consultant. We are IT Genius. We help small and medium-sized business owners with the technology. We help get all their tech running in flow. And if you're new to our channel or to checking out our content, thank you so much for joining. Please make sure you're subscribed and click the notification bell so you can get access to all of our videos as they come out. Now, our growth roadmap is the roadmap of technology adoption for small businesses. And we use this to guide business owners through the different stages of business and where they should be focusing their attention and growth as they grow out through their business journey and how it relates to the technology that they work with. Now, right now we're focusing on the growth stage. This is really for business owners who've got through launch, they've got through startup, they've got all the kind of basics done, and now their business is more maturing. And what tends to happen when businesses start to mature a little bit more is you start to have things get a little bit messier. And so growth businesses, it's really about tidying things up and getting everything in a logical state. And, you know, making sure the business model is all perfected, but also you want your technology to get a little bit more perfected as well, so you can prepare to get into scale mode. Growth is really about building the systems, getting really tight on them, and then making sure your team have the right technology tools in hand, because after you get out of the growth stage and you get to scale, well, then it's all about people and culture and just making sure that everyone is a bit more supported on the people side of things. So today we're talking about growth, and if you haven't checked out our other videos on our growth roadmap, then you can check those out on our channel. So why would we be focusing on moving a G Suite account or moving our personal data into G Suite? Why is that important for us? And why is this going to be useful for you as a business owner? Well, the why for this is a kind of three-pronged approach. There's three things that are important for this, and I'm going to take you through them right now. So number one, you want to make sure that you have a clear separation between what's work stuff and what's personal stuff. Now, many business owners, when they have everything in one Google account, you kind of become a bit enmeshed to the business. And I like to think of myself as a CEO of a business. That's my job role day to day. But as the shareholder of the business and the board member and the investor in the business, I actually need to be able to step back and have, like, let's say, a bit of a third party perspective in operating that business. Now, that's hard to do if your whole digital life is literally enmeshed with the business. And so if you're stuck in a place of absolutely everything is happening inside your business G Suite account, then that's going to be difficult for you to actually work that out. And so what that means is when we separate the two accounts, you're going to have a bit better separation of, like, church and state, right? Between your personal stuff and your business stuff. Now, it goes without saying, if one day you're going to sell your business or exit from your business, you don't want to have to, like, pull out and undo all of that stuff from the business and try and extract your personal information from your business account. So it's better to set it up now before the business grows and changes. And you might be wondering, well, Pete, why wouldn't I just use a Gmail account? Or why wouldn't I use a Hotmail account or whatever other account I have outside the business? We'll come to that a little bit later, but one of the most important things about this is you have more security and you have more control over a G Suite account than you do with a Gmail account. Unfortunately, from time to time, we hear of many business owners who have Gmail accounts disappear. They just disappear off the face of the earth, or they become locked out and they find it really hard to get access again. And part of the reason for that is because Google have literally 2 billion Gmail accounts that they need to support. And so there's no business hotline that you can just call and have someone give you access back to your Gmail account. There's a whole convoluted process of, trying to get your identity proven and get your account back. Now, we've had business owners who have sometimes run businesses out of a personal Gmail account and literally had their whole business shut down because everything was in a Gmail account. Gmail account got disconnected, and then they were just not able to access it for months at a time. And so if you think, yeah, that's pretty bad for a business, it could be completely devastating, but what if that was your family photos? What if that was your personal emails? What if that was important documents that you had in Google Drive with memories and personal files and personal information, all under a Gmail account that could maybe have its access lost? Now, you might be saying, well, Pete, yeah, someone can hack into my G Suite account as well. Yes, that is possible. But as long as you own and control the domain name associated with a G Suite account, you can always get back in. The other thing is, with a G Suite account, because you're paying for the licenses, you get access to business support. So if something goes wrong, it's probably going to be resolved within a matter of hours rather than days or even weeks. And so I'm a big fan of using G Suite. I just don't know if I can trust a personal Gmail account to put all of my digital life outside of the business with IT Genius. So we've covered that off. Let's cover off the final one on the why, and that is really about recovery. We've taken care of that. Yes, the final one is your identity. And we're going to start talking about identity. I'm going to go into a little bit of detail on that. And the identity is really about, okay, what is the identity of you in the Google world, right? So in the Google world, what is the identity of you? Let's talk a little bit more about that. Now, you would know that when you go and sign up for something like YouTube, or you're using an online service like maybe eBay or Gumtree, there's a little button there, and you can click that button and it will automatically log you into the app or the account. That's called a social login. And before Facebook was doing it, before Apple was doing it, Google were one of the first ones to allow people to sign in using that social login. And that identity allows you to actually access lots of different applications. Now, if you're a business owner and you're using your business login for all of these different sites, if you ever had to sell the business or exit the business for any reason, you would have all of those identities tied to your business account, which can be a little bit of a pain to have to undo and, you know, back your way back out of all of those. And so having an identity that is your personal identity that stays with you forever, because your business is not going to be forever, but your identity is forever, makes it a good idea to use a G Suite account for that. And so that's why I prefer using a G Suite account for this. I think it's a bit more professional to have a personal domain rather than @gmail.com for my personal emails, because it might be something related to investment. It might be something related to a personal project outside of my business. I like having my personal domain name so that I can access that. And so identity becomes very important for you to be able to do that. Now, not only your identity with things like, logging into the eBays and the Gumtrees, well, what about logging into something like YouTube? When I am using YouTube as a consumer, I want YouTube to serve up all of those recommendations for me, right? I want them to, watch my watching habits and watch my my reading habits and actually give me really good quality recommendations. Now, the challenge that I have is if I'm using my business account, when I'm working during the day, I might be looking up videos on our own channel, I might be looking up competitors, I might be looking up stuff from Google for my kind of work mode. When I get home and I'm in my personal mode, I don't really want the algorithm to be showing me all of that worky kind of stuff. I don't really want to have an enmeshment between my work tasks and my home tasks, and I'd prefer to have a bit of separation with that. I also don't want to be halfway through a presentation and open up my business YouTube channel or my business YouTube profile and all of a sudden have all of my personal stuff showing up in the business. That's not just because I'm worried about any of that being shown, but it's because I'd prefer to have a nice clean separation. So when I can be productive, I don't want to be distracted by the other stuff, more the personal life stuff. I'm really big on, having the priority and the discipline of making sure that when you're in work mode, you're in work mode. And then when you're in home mode, you're really present with your family and the people around you in that home personal mode. And so I like having them separated. That's my way of doing things. And this allows me to do that. So when you have that identity is going to be what's going to help you, making sure that you have a account which is suitable for you to use everything. A couple of final ones that I should probably mention that are useful there is I also use an Asana account for my personal tasks. So like running the house, doing any personal projects, I have a separate Asana task management account, which I use, and I use that to share tasks with my assistant when I want to delegate delegate it. And my partner can also, you know, we can have tasks in there as well. So if we're like, I don't know, purchasing a vehicle and we want to drop notes in there, or we're looking at a property, we can put all of those things inside an Asana task. Surprise, surprise, it's linked to my personal account. The last one, which I should make mention, and this is kind of like a minor mention, but Google Maps. If you're using Google Maps and you're saving places to your Google Maps, if you ever exited outside of your business and you decided to go and, you know, do something completely different, you don't want to lose all of that data in your Google identity. Google Keep would be another one. I just keep thinking about all of these. But having the identity separate is super, super useful. Let's keep moving on to the next one.